The topic for this lesson is a general introduction to DC and AC circuits. A basic direct current circuit consists of a source of electrical force, such as a battery, that is connected to various components with a return path to the source. The flow of current in the circuit is then in a particular direction. This flow can be compared to a closed-loop hydraulic motor in a simple recirculating system. A DC circuit then, when connected or switched on, exhibits a constant flow of current in one direction through the circuit unless something changes in the circuit. For example, source voltage changes or a circuit resistance value alters. The value of this current is determined by the source voltage and the total resistance in the circuit. In the case of an AC circuit, the source voltage or electric pressure reverses in a periodic manner. This means that current flows through the circuit first in one direction, positive, and then the other, negative. From maximum positive current to maximum negative current is known as the amplitude. Also, one complete period from zero to maximum positive, back to zero, down to maximum negative, and back to zero again is known as a cycle. The frequency of the AC current is equal to the number of cycles per second. Cycle per second is now termed Hertz and abbreviated HZ. Three terms are used to describe AC parameters: peak, average, and root mean square, or RMS. Peak is the maximum point on a sine wave. Both peaks, positive and negative, may be included in a reference. If so, this becomes a peak-to-peak value. A peak value of 100 volts means that the peak-to-peak value is 200 volts. The average value of all the instantaneous values taken at regular intervals of an AC current is 0.637 times the peak. This means that a peak value of 100 volts is equal to an average value of 63.7 volts. Therefore, average value is equal to 0.637 times peak. The term root mean square, or RMS, is used most often. It is a method used for equating DC to AC. If we break an AC sine wave into four parts, each containing 90 degrees of the complete cycle needed to generate 1 Hertz, we will find that the instantaneous voltage and current, when taken 90 times, once for each degree, and squared, then averaged, and the square root taken of the average, we will get 0.7071 times the peak value of the sine wave. The same value would be obtained by taking the sine of 45 degrees, one half of 90 degrees. We must remember that the shape of the waveform is more like a sine wave. RMS value, therefore, is equal to 0.7071 times the peak. Another characteristic of AC is that both the voltage and current are continually changing in similar cycles. Very infrequently, however, do the voltage and current both attain maximum and zero values at precisely the same time. In other words, the current curve, or waveform, is displaced relative to the voltage curve, or waveform. This displacement is known as phase difference. It is normally expressed in terms of the ratio of the actual displacement to a full cycle length on the zero line, multiplied by 360, since a full cycle represents 360 degrees corresponding to the AC curve. This is known as the phase angle. Generally, the current will peak after the voltage, that is, displaced to the right as shown in the figure, whereupon the current is said to be lagging and the phase angle is referred to as angle of lag. However, in some cases the current can lead the voltage.